also Sundara is joined. Sundara, I think she's from
Baseball.
So you both speak in English, you say it's okay. So before we proceed to this poem, let me ask you what you have understood from the previous poem. So this boy, have you gone through the poem on killing a tree? Remaining should be silent because see, barely gets. On killing a tree, what do you have understood you say? Just 2 minutes reflection I will have and then I will go to the next poem. So many are there outsiders, they have joined, so you'll be quiet. Yes. So, dear students, outsiders, we are just discussing the previous poem, okay? So, you just listen to it. I'm asking the students who are beginning to present here. So, you listen to them, so you'll be able to hear. And then we'll start this new one. Yes. With this.
Sir, we should not cut trees and
Shubham, what is the inside message that the poet would like to give in this poem? The inside message.
Sir, in this poem, the poet tries to tell that we should not cut a tree and it takes so many efforts to cut a tree.
Very interesting. Answer you give me. Yes.
So the poet says that we should not kill a, we should not kill a tree. It also has some feelings and. It also has some feelings, it has also pain if we cut the tree.
Sir, in this poem, poet is telling do not cut a tree because it takes long time to grow a sapling of a tree. It's easy to cut a tree but hard to grow a tree.
So yesterday I mentioned that the poet is describing different process or different methods on how to kill a tree. So it doesn't mean that the poet likes the people who cut trees. Did you understand? Rather, he is ironically making the statement that the people have become so selfish. These days the human society has become so selfish that they don't lack behind to cut a tree. So, if you are killing a tree, it means that you are killing a human being. Clear? So, yesterday I told you also that if you kill a tree, if you attempt to kill any tree, single tree also, then you are attempting to kill one of your family members. You have flesh and blood, isn't it? So, similarly, the tree also has flesh.
Sir, the point somewhere, he has a
human being. Clear. So irony in the figures of speech which might come in your examination, that irony I mentioned while teaching the poem. So irony means Shubham. One word it was used that ironically the poem is giving the statement. Irony. So what do you mean by this irony? This is not mentioned in your poem. But it will come in exam. Suppose which figures of speech is used in the poem? Utility words. Manushka, irony means what?
So means if someone is telling something, but he means something else.
Very good. Suppose Shubham is deliberately committing the mistake, but the teacher replies that very good, excellent, well done. It means but teacher is not of this age so.
Sir, it is bad wala.
Yes.
It is not.
Speaking something in front of you, but meaning is something different. Clear?
Sir, this becomes omelette or we selling very good. That one.
Yes.
Sir, the one.
Sit down. So Sandhya Mulchandani, so we'll start a new poem. So I think tomorrow it's your turn to come to school. So Sandhya will come tomorrow onwards. So you see the poem, I'm just giving you 1 minute time to go with the poem, the snake trying. Then we'll discuss line by line. The snake trying. Don't make noise. Anyone who is producing sound will come near the camera and will teach. So that the other students who are outsiders, they will listen to you. I'll call one student. So you read very silently. So I'll give you a chance to speak in front of camera also today. So that the public can see you. Because you have never faced speaking before live YouTube. I don't think that only you students are watching it. Other students also are watching. Many relatives of me from Odisha also they watch when I'm taking the class. My father-in-law, many more are there. So today they'll get a chance to see you also. Don't laugh, you'll read. So outsiders, you all of you, please do read the text for a minute. Then I'll start. Only for a minute. You can go with the text. And also your textbook. I don't like to scold the students who are at your age because you are very much grown up. They should understand. The teachers should not scold. It is your duty that I should carry a book with your family to school. At least we are lucky that you are getting a chance to come to school. Because so many schools are there, still we have not. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So before you share, let me tell you, give you the brief introduction of this poem. So this is written by, it's a very small poem, very short poem, written by Okay. So this poem, it is very simple one and silly also, but very silly poem also you can consider it. So what are the lines you know, like class 2, 3 students tell me the activities. So for line standard, you might consider it a very silly poem. But it can convey you a strong message. Because I have already told you that each and every lesson is being imparted to you. That will give you a lesson. So you can practically apply them. So I don't think that many of you may not be applying it in your practical life. So many lessons and morals you are getting. Each and every story, lesson, it can be silly also. Like the ant and the cricket. Very simple poem. You read in class 8. So you might be thinking this is a very silly poem, but it can give you a profound message. It can convey a strong message. Clear? So what is happening actually in this poem? In this poem, the poet, listen to me, okay? Because I will call you now. And I will sit in place of you. And I will just go with my mobile how you are speaking. So all students can see also. Okay? So you don't interrupt here. And while you come here, so you try to speak well. So this is a chance I am giving you. Okay? So let the chance, we'll obtain this chance. So in this poem, the poet is trying to say that all snakes are not poisonous. Not every snake is poisonous. So many snakes are running here and there in our colony. See, I have been encountered by many times so many snakes. Even some snakes I have seen, they have crawled on my feet.
We
are quiet. We also have to. I am giving you my example in our colony. But the snakes are very decent here. The colony snakes, the snakes which are found in our colony, they are very, very decent. But I am telling you the snakes which we find in our colony. They are very decent. But see, I have never ever heard anyone who has been bitten by any snake here. I have been working in this particular school near about 8 to 7 years. But I have never heard anyone who is bitten by any snake here. So not all snakes can be poisonous. Some snakes are poisonous, like king cobra, rattlesnake, or your Russell viper. Okay. So recently Santoshi Ben's Moses' son, I think he was bitten by a Russell viper and now he is in ICU, I think. Santoshi Ben's Moses' son, I don't know who is that boy. So he's of 20 years age, that child. So he was working in field. So immediately the snake did bite him twice and the person was hospitalized. And see, every part of the body is being paralyzed slowly, slowly. Okay, your blood will melt in the water. So some snakes are very poisonous, but not all snakes can be poisonous. Some snakes I have seen when I was a student like you, I used to play with them. I used to lift them, I used to throw them. Some snakes which are found in water, they are harmless.
Yes, sir.
Did you understand? But some snakes are dangerous. And it is very difficult task to identify which is poisonous and which is harmless one. How many of you know that, or how many of you can guess that this snake is poisonous and this is harmless one? Are you able to identify?
Yes,
sir. So after biting, you come Yes, this is very true also. See, unless and until we experience anything, then we are not able to understand. But I am telling you, almost all of your parents, they can easily identify which one is harmless and which is poisonous. At least I can rectify, you know, minimum 10 to 8 snakes, whether they are harmless or harmful also. Yes?
Rat snake.
So you hold up, let me see what outsiders are getting writing in comment. Let me open it. Open this. Okay, Riddhi, you have written some black color snakes are poisonous, I think.
No, no, not all that.
Not all black colors.
See, this one is English. You listen only. Light plus is going on. Listen.
Okay. Okay. So, in this poem, so some of them are quite harmless, Jitan. So they will not come to you by themselves to bite you. Clear? But I am telling you very interesting thing about snakes, that when the snake hears the approach of any man, human being coming on his way, then it will try to escape. Because it can hear you through vibration. Okay? Because it doesn't have ears. So it can listen to you, it can hear you very clearly through vibration, and it will try to escape. Until and unless the snake is filled or he is feeling unprotected. If the snake feels unprotected, then it will in reverse bite you. Otherwise, I think even dangerous snake also will try to escape. No snake deliberately would like to bite any human being. Remember this point. By chance, someone might put my feet on any cobra snake. Then in return, it can bite you. But intentionally, I am telling you, no snake even will come to you.
Yes, sir.
No, no. If it is hungry also, especially to human beings, it will not give any harm. Clear? It will not do any harm to human beings. Rather, if it is hungry, then it can eat any other insects.
So, maybe it takes small prey for.
Yes. So, if they are undisturbed, snakes will not bite us. If snakes are undisturbed, then they will never bite you. And they only bite you in self-protection. Did you understand? Snakes only bite human beings in self-protection. In order to protect themselves, they can bite you in reverse. So, never consider that or don't be mistaken or don't develop any such negative ideas about snakes that all snakes can be dangerous or they can be harmful. Because after 5 minutes, I am calling you. So, I am just watching a child and anyone can be easily called. So, on the other hand, the human being is always driven by his instinct of fear of snake and runs after any snake in his sight to kill it. But we have developed a wrong notion every time in our mind that any harmless snake also when we are approaching, that we feel that the snake might do any harm or it can bite us, and the human being will run after it intentionally and finally will kill it. So it has happened.
Yes, sir.
Now, suppose here also many times I have seen, but here the people are very good also. Safety department people, they come and they can rescue the snake. So many times we have seen, people who came for physical classes, one snake was found while Ankur sir was teaching, when he was teaching in that class. So that was poisonous snake. The people identified as poisonous, but they didn't kill him, rather they rescued him. And they left it in our forest.
But it will come again if it is not killed. Then it will come again.
But it will not bite. Okay. So we human beings, we have that fear of snake every time in our mind. And we run after any snake to kill it. The human being thinks that snake means Denzel liked. Clear? Denzel liked it. Like that. And so it has to be killed by at any cost. At all means. But that is not true. So we people have wrong notion that every snake is poisonous. So better we should kill them. So you are mistaken. So don't think that all snakes can be dangerous. So you can take the experts' advices also that better know from them which snakes are poisonous and which are not poisonous. So Pratibha, are you able to identify any snake which is poisonous? So your father, better you can seek advice from your father. Your father is a highly experienced person. So he can better tell you. So which are the poisonous snakes, because he might have seen so many snakes during his stay in Ambuja. Okay, I think your father might have served Ambuja for more than 20 years.
13 or 14.
Okay, so the vast experience your father has. So better you should ask from him. Okay, so therefore the poet here through this poem is trying to convey a message that all snakes are not poisonous. One message you are getting, that all snakes are not poisonous. So don't kill them. Clear? Don't kill them. They will not bite you unless and until harm or destruct. So if at all they bite us, then they will do so only in self-defense. If somebody is bitten, if you heard somebody is bitten by any snake, then that is only because of self-defense. Oh yes, we. Because of self-defense only the snake can bite you. Otherwise, the snake will never do any harm to you.
Yes.
Okay. So, in our countries, in many places, you must have seen people still worship snakes also.
Yes, sir.
So, why to kill them? Yes. So, so most of them are non-poisonous. Clear? So, however, there are some poisonous snakes also which bite human beings and other animals on being harmed and destructed and lives are lost. So, when they feel that, when the snake feels that my life be lost now, then it can bite you. Or it can bite other animals also. Clear? But still, we have to be very much careful and we'll try to keep ourselves away from the snakes which are poisonous, not all snakes. Clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
He is listening to me, but he is understanding everything. Okay. And I have seen on Arunay, this boy has a very good writing skill. And almost many of you have good writing skill. Subham also has a good writing skill. And if you have good writing skill from 9th onwards, so in 10th standard, suppose the traditional pattern, not MCQ pattern, again the CBSE is thinking, once the schools reopen, then the as usual pattern will be followed. And there, if you have good writing skill, then more than 95 marks you can score in English. I am sure that more than 95. And those who are, because grammar portion will be very less. Grammar portion will be very less, only 5 to 7 marks. So writing, Divyanka, you also... now you have started writing well. So all the students, you go on practicing. Don't take it very lightly, because many of you have wrong notion in your mind that English subject is very, very easy, so anyone can get past mark. But you are not studying well to get past mark. Because you have seen last time survey we have made there, the children have taken English paper very lightly, and in other subjects, they have scored very good marks, but because of English, their percentage has gone down. And as a result, they have not got seats in good or reputed college further. Kam mark aayega to aapko seat bhi nahi milega. Abhi competition chal raha hai. 99.5 jo laayega usse jyada. 98-99 common hai CBSE mein. 80% bhi la rahe ho, then you are failed. In CBSE, those who are scoring only 70%, 75%, equivalent to 10 mark. So this time you will be surprised that the children are not able to score good marks in any paper also. See, I buy my paper on science and commerce, English paper, recently, board exam paper. So, how many students are getting out of 20, 18 marks, 17 marks, and you see the marks. Wherever they have left, they have put tick mark. Blindly, you can't do anything. So, that is why I am asking you, insisting you always to read very sincerely. Some are understanding, some are reading also. But some are still taking the things very lightly. See, nothing will happen to us. We will be in this same place, but we will get stuck. We will not go ahead. So, 9th standard, this is the very crucial age, I am telling you, crucial time. So, if you start working hard, because we have seen so many students' life which has been drastically changed. ऐसे एक एक बच्चे थे जो भी कुछ भी नहीं आता था बट नाइन्थ ऑनवर्ड्स ऐसे पिकअप लिए वो लोग कि यू वोंट बिलीव दैट कि ऐसा कैसे हो गया दिस इज मिरेकल तो तुम भी कर सकते हो मिरेकल कोई भी कर सकता है क्लियर सो कम टू द स्टेंजा नंबर वन The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curving of thin, long body. How beautiful and graceful are his steps. He glides through the water away from the stroke. What you are understanding what the snake is doing in stanza number one?
He's trying to escape from the stick.
So in the first six lines, the poet is saying that a snake, especially the poet is talking about a harmless garden snake. Here the snake is a garden snake who lives in, always found in garden. And especially I am telling you, all garden snakes, whatever the snakes you find in our colony also, in garden also, these all are harmless, not at all, they can be poisonous. But in forest one, suppose if you find any snake or you are bitten by any snake, then immediately you have to go to hospital. Don't rely on the people who believe in old practices in our villages, remote villages also. So the personal lives will immediately go. So instead of waiting for the old practices or beliefs by the people, better is to go to hospital. But I am telling you, if you are bitten by any snake while playing in garden also, don't be afraid of. This will not do any harm to you. Clear? 90% snakes are harmless. But 1% I don't know whether it can be poisonous also. I don't know. So in the first six line, you can see the poet is saying that a snake, harmless green colored snake, trying to escape from a man with a stick. Somebody is holding a stick and trying to chase the snake, and the snake is trying to escape from there. It means from there you can come to conclusion that the snake might be a harmless one. If a snake is getting afraid of you, then what you understand? Of course, it can be a harmless snake. It is trying to save its life. So better we should understand one thing there, that the snake can be harmless one. So don't chase it. The human being, the man is chasing it to kill it. And the snake, in order to escape, what it is doing? Sudden cuts in its body and is trying to move very quickly. And this movement, in a zigzag way, it is trying to run away from it. So the movement it is running from your side, then if you look at the snake very carefully, then you see the side, complete side, how beautiful and graceful this is. When the cobra is standing in this position, spreading its food, okay, standing in front of you, then you see the beautiful side, how lovely the pigs is. How graceful, how beautiful the complete sight. Have you seen it?
Yes,
on Discovery Channel you might have seen, and some snake charmers also they come to. I have seen so many times because when I was a student like you also, so snake charmers they used to come to our village Okay, so many snakes they used to carry and they used to show us. Okay, very beautifully they used to dance, the snakes. So it is a very beautiful sight to see. Okay, so the poet is describing that when the snake is moving in a zigzag manner, curving its body and moving very quickly, that particular sight, that movement of the snake, it creates a beautiful and graceful shapes. And it can fascinate the poet even also. It can charm you, it can look very beautiful. Moreover, the snake, it is moving through the water in order to save itself from the heat of that stick. So the poet has seen the snake in the water. This is a garden snake actually. Unfortunately, it came into water and it is moving in a very zigzag manner. And the poet is trying to hit him. Not the poet, a person. A human being. So whenever the poet is observing that sight, so it really fascinates him. Fascinates you, understand? It is creating a beautiful memory in his mind. Okay, so it is charming the poet. Usko maja lag raha hai. Bahut achha lag raha hai. ऐसा सीन रियल में देखने के लिए मिलता है जैसे किंग कोबरा एंड मंगूज फाइट. ओके, दीज आर रियली सीन एंड व्हाट एवर यू आर ऑब्जर्विंग और वॉचिंग ऑन द डिस्कवरी चैनल ऑल्सो आई एम टेलिंग यू. सो द पीपल हु आर शूटिंग टेकिंग द फोटो शूट दे यूज टू स्टे ओवर देयर फॉर सो मेनी डेज टू क्रिएट दैट सीन. लोग ऐसा नहीं कि तुरंत गया हूँ, आज मैंने गया अब मेरे को देखने के लिए मिलेगा, मैं फोटो खींच गया, ऐसा नहीं होता. आपको बैठना पड़ेगा, कोई चीज आपको आपको हफ्ते से दस दिन तक बैठना मतलब बनना देगा. Then we take the fix. Similarly, your height कब आएगा वो सेम. Then you have to observe closely. आपको छुपके से बैठना पड़ेगा उस जगह पर और ध्यान से रहना पड़ेगा कि ऐसा मोमेंट कब आने वाला है. Then you not confirm और ये fixed नहीं रहेगा तो और luckily आपको मिल गया वो सेम. So I hope that stanza one it is understood. So Sharma, abhi mask hata to main tumhara control kar raha hu. Tum sab log ground mein koi mask laga khelte ho kya? Nobody is playing. Yes, Sharma.
Sir, I wrote somebody.